air we breathe, whether it be from cars on the roadways or emissions from plants near the ship channel, we're all affected. But the dangers of persistent pollution hit some commuters harder than others.
In today's Stronger Houston report, KPRC2's Sion Rhodes focuses on a movement that doesn't get as much attention as some others. It's a struggle to correct decades of environmental injustice and save lives.
For many people in Houston, the neighbor next door isn't a person. It's a chemical plant.
It's not healthy for us.
A concrete batch plant.
The dust, there's a lot of dust.
Or an old rail yard.
As a child, I remember smelling that creosote.
And it's making them sick.
I watched my mom die from cancer. I lost my brother-in-law, my husband. I said all of them died from cancer.
But only certain neighborhoods bear the brunt.
Poor black and brown communities are experiencing more of the burdens of environmental injustice and which we call environmental racism as well.
Texas Housers, a nonprofit focused on solving housing and community development issues, mapped industrial hazardous waste sites and sources of air pollution in Houston. They found those places were concentrated in low-income black and Hispanic communities, outlined here in red, versus more affluent white neighborhoods outlined in blue. Researchers say it's no accident.
Facilities intentionally place themselves in communities and near communities where they will not, in many cases, not all cases, but in many cases, will not get pushback from the communities. When they do get pushback from the communities, it still doesn't stop them from placing themselves there.
Do something.
Sandra Edwards is pushing back.
You see what's going on? Why sit on your butt?
The longtime Fifth Ward resident lives down the street from a rail yard where a cancer-causing chemical known as creosote was once used, polluting the air and the drinking water.
It's a lot needs to be done out here, and they act like they don't hear our plea.
In 2019, state health investigators discovered a cancer cluster of higher rates of the disease in the area. In January, a second cluster was found, this time unusually high rates of leukemia in children.
It's heartbreaking.
As president of a neighborhood-led group called Impact, she's fighting for residents to be relocated, for coverage of health care costs, and for the area to be declared a Superfund site.
We are talking to people, we are writing letters, and we still get no recognition, we still get no attention, we still get no results.
Accountability is hard to come by. According to a 2017 report, from 2011 to 2016, less than 3% of air emissions violations resulted in a penalty by the Texas Commission on Environmental Quality.
And when you all consider that we're not enforcing the existing laws, there's no incentive for companies to then follow the rules.
A coalition of groups working toward environmental justice say residents need stronger protections to help them keep these industries out of their neighborhoods and more responsive elected officials willing to make polluters pay.
How can we make those solutions prioritize those communities that they've been suffering the most?
We're just asking you to help us. Please help us.
Houston's lack of zoning, another big reason why these places are able to pop up in neighborhoods. Several state legislators are working on bills that would prevent these industries from being placed close to homes and schools. Sion Rhodes, KPRC 2 News.